All right, I want everyone to listen closely now. This is actually the story you've been waiting for all morning, isn't it, Jeff?
Stop it.
Could be the most important information you're going to hear between now and next year.
If you're planning to celebrate the start of 2012, Dr. Holly Phillips is here to help you avoid or treat the dreaded hangover.
Very good, Jeff. And you've been waiting for this story.
Oh, yes. Can't wait. So we know it causes a hangover. What's actually going on inside the body?
Well, you know what? Really, it's obviously from too much drinking, but the idea is that drinking causes you to produce more urine, and that dehydrates you. That causes that sort of sense of headache, nausea, fatigue. It also irritates your stomach lining, making nausea worse. And then finally, it lowers your blood sugar, which gives you that shakiness and just that whole sense of being out of it. It's not a good feeling.
So what is the holy grail, then, of hangover cures?
You know, Rebecca, if there were a holy grail, I think we would have found it by now. People have been drinking for a very long time. But there are some new products that just hit the market in time for New Year's Eve.
That claim to work.
That claim to work. You know, the jury's still very much out on that. This one is called Bitox. It is a patch. You put it on you put it on your forearm or
put it on now, Jeff.
You try, Jarv?
Well, actually,
preemptively.
How long do you wear the patch for?
Well, you put it on 45 minutes before having your first drink.
She does a couple shots after the show.
I'm already in trouble.
And then you wear it for 8 hours after your last drink.
Where do you
drink.
Put it on? Anywhere? It doesn't matter?
Yeah, anywhere that doesn't have hair.
Somewhere on your face, Jeff.
So really your forearm or... Yeah, he can wear it right on his forehead.
The box claims that it works by
replacing vitamins that are lost from
alcohol. Okay, because I was looking at the ingredients on the back.
FDA hasn't approved it?
No. Well, the FDA hasn't backed up that now.
Vitamin A, B.
It doesn't need FDA approval, actually.
It just basically looks like a lot of vitamins.
It's a lot of vitamins, and they say that that's how it works. The other one is called Blowfish. It dissolves in a glass of water like this, which is good because then, of course, that forces you to rehydrate. It is a mix of aspirin, caffeine, and an antacid just to soothe your stomach.
Again,
the FDA, pretty much, the FDA has not weighed in on this, but they don't need to because the active ingredients don't require their approval. It's just caffeine and aspirin.
That creeps me out a little bit, though. I would rather, you know, take an Excedrin or something like that that I know has been FDA approved.
Sure.
Or maybe deal with a cure that maybe you can find in your own kitchen or something like that. Or you could take the
components separately. You could have a cup of coffee for your caffeine and take an aspirin.
How much caffeine? So 60 milligrams in the Blowfish. So that's what Excedrin is, right?
Pretty much.
It's about the same amount of caffeine.
Yep.
Different alcohols, different effects?
You know what? Darker alcohols, sort of the brandies, scotch, they have something in them called congeners. And it gives the alcohol its flavor, but it's thought to create a worse hangover than clear things like vodka and gin. So you could keep that in mind. But really, if you drink too much of anything, you're going to be feeling the effects. So it's all about prevention for hangovers as opposed to the cure.
And it seems like, I mean, different people can drink different amounts of alcohol and have a much different impact. How different do you know are men from women in terms of alcohol habits and consumption?
In general, men get hangovers less than women do
really?
From the same amount of alcohol. It has to do with body mass. Men tend to be bigger, and they also have more what we call alcohol dehydrogenase in the liver, which helps to metabolize the alcohol. So they win the they win the contest.
Congratulations,
on that one.
Jeff.
Thank you very much.
We might have won the contest Hollywood this year, but you guys win the drinking contest.
Holly, interesting stuff. So Bitox and Blowfish. But you're essentially talking about taking vitamins and caffeine.
And aspirin. Yeah. So you know what? This may make it a little bit better. But honestly, if there were some real magic cure, we would have found it
by now. If you overdrink, you're not going to feel well.
Not so good.
Drink responsibly. Yeah. Dr. Holly Phillips, thanks so much for being with us. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year
to you. Have a toast for us.
Yeah. Will do.